Hello, I'm Sauki, and I'm here again in Vuokatti. We are having our holiday, and I have my bike with me. I have been here before, and I've made a video about this before. We are now in Vuokatti area having our winter holiday, and of course I had to take my bike with me. It was about 2 years ago. There's this big hill, and I'm going to attempt again, try to cycle on top of that hill. In winter conditions. Last time I had my Suomi tires, studded winter tires with me, but now I have these Continental studless winter tires. This is already starting to feel like a bad idea because look at this. There's a lot of ice underneath the snow. So I may not have enough traction to go up that hill because it's pretty steep hill. Last time I had to stop at least 2 times to rest in the middle of the hill. And even then I had a little bit problem with the traction with the rear wheel. But now I think this is going to be difficult. And I think this is going to be a pretty short video if I don't have enough traction to go up that hill. And it seems that it's already getting dark. This is the darkest time of the year. It's about 2.5 weeks to the Christmas. But anyway, here starts the pain. Damn it! Fuck this shit! It's going to be pretty difficult to start here. Meters more. Not bad. Rear wheel is slipping. Yes, I made it to the top. Okay, so I made it to the top. Here I am on this parking spot. Actually the hill continues that way, but there's no proper road. And there's this downhill skiing place, so I'm not allowed to cycle over there. So this is the highest spot I can go on this road. And I was a bit surprised that I did have enough traction with those tires. About a few hundred meters before this parking spot, it started to slip a little bit. But there was some ice on underneath the snow, so that's why it started to slip. Luckily we had some new snow and now on this road, because there's cars driving, it's now hard packed snow, so it's much better traction than on ice. Because yesterday, before this snowfall, I think the road was pretty much covered on ice, so it would have been impossible to ride up this hill with these Continental tires.
Let's quickly look at few things from Strava. So here's this hill, as you can see, and here's another view. You can see it's not the highest point where this parking spot is. But anyway, let's look at this segment someone has created here. Here we can see this was about 1.4 kilometers long climb with average grade of 9%. For me, this is like a mountain, because where I come from, we don't have this kind of hills. It's almost completely flat. Well, not as flat as the Netherlands, but still quite flat. This time my time on this climb was 11 minutes and 39 seconds. I didn't have to stop in the middle this time. Here we can also see the time of my last attempt almost 2 years ago. Then I had to stop few times, so it took almost 15 minutes to get on top of the hill. If we look at this leaderboard, we can see most of the attempts are made in summer. But here at the end of the list, I found other crazy people who have climbed this hill in winter, like me. My time wasn't even close to the fastest winter time on this list, but at least I wasn't the slowest one. But anyway, recumbents can climb, even in winter.
Okay, now I'll just go for a little ride around here, this place. I don't have any specific plans. I'll just go somewhere and maybe show you some clips about that. Okay then, let's see how fast I can go downhill. Well, maybe I'm not going so fast because it's pretty slippery here. It was getting hot when I came up here, but now I'm probably going to freeze. So nice view that I have to take a photo here. Well, you can't capture this in the photo. And it probably looks pretty boring in the video as well. Yeah, whatever. I have to be careful with the brakes. Don't want to brake too much because then I'm going to crash. Didn't die. Okay, I think that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Please remember to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. Just click the subscription button below the video. And click that bell icon if you haven't done it already, so you can get notification every time I post a new video. And then visit my webshop and buy something. But okay, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.